I am very excited to introduce the next honoree, and I'm glad that I was assigned to introduce her. Although she retired from competitive swimming in 2007, sport is a strong part of her life. She swims, bikes, runs, and plays golf, and still looks terrific. A great testament to the health benefits of our sports. She is also an active member of her country's Olympic Committee and Swimming Federation, in addition to being a university professor and a mom. Let's find out more about her.
Agnes Kovacs learned to swim when she was just 2.5 years old and loved the water from the very start. She made rapid progress. At the age of 13, she had her first success in the Hungarian National Age Group Championships. And as a 14-year-old, won the European Junior Championship in the 100-yard breaststroke. Within days of her 15th birthday, she won the Olympic bronze medal at the 200-meter breaststroke in Atlanta in 1996. Following in the wake of Hall of Famer Krisztina Egerzegi, Agnes would be named Hungary's best female swimmer and her country's Sportswoman of the Year for the next 4 years. Dominating the 200-meter breaststroke in all international competition from 1997 to 2000, she won gold at both the FINA World Championships in 1998 and then the Olympic gold medal at Sydney in 2000. Following her Olympic success, Kovacs won her event again at the 2001 FINA Championships in Fukuoka, Japan, before moving to the United States to attend Arizona State University. When she left ASU in 2005, it was as a 15-time All-American, as the school's top senior female athlete, and with a degree in supply chain management. Returning to Hungary, she rejoined the national team program and was a crowd favorite, winning 3 medals at the 2006 European Championships in the same pool where she first learned to swim 22 years earlier, on Budapest's historic Margaret Island. Agnes won a total of 25 medals at the European Championships, long course and short course, and was a 53-time Hungarian national champion from 1996 through 2007. Agnes Kovacs, honor swimmer, Hungary.
Good evening to everybody. First of all, I just would like to say thank you. And I'm very pleased I can be here. And it was just a long journey, the last 6 months, what we did, especially with Meg, and it was just a great experience. Just to live again what I did back ago, not a long time ago, but I retired in 2007. It was 6 years ago. When I started to swim, I was just 2.5. And I just really great to my parents. They took me to the pool and taught me what is love sports and what is the love of the water. Later on, I stuck in the pool. It was not just always up. Sometimes, you know, life is like that, just going up and going down, and sometimes easier, sometimes harder. But I just stayed in the pool. And when I saw the Olympic Games in 1988, there was a female swimmer. Her name is Krisztina Egerzegi. Until she's career finished, she won 5 gold medals at the Olympic Games. I was just 7 years old, but I just looked at the TV and I told my mom, I'm gonna beat her. I'm gonna be a champion. And my mom said, all right. Around that time, I was not too talented. Not too later, we went to a competition. And actually, I was in trouble because my coach tried to talk me how to do a new turn. It was not too successful because it was a medley, and I tried to turn from backstroke to breaststroke, but I couldn't. So I was kind of under the water for like 20 seconds or 30, I'm not sure. And all the others almost finished the race. Agnes is still under the water. My mom is ready to jump in and screaming. And everybody was like, oh my gosh. So finally I came up, and then everybody was staring, what's gonna happen? And I came up, and everybody talked, okay, she finished, probably she's done with swimming. But I did not. I didn't go out. I kept going. I finished my race. I was far behind, but I finished it. And everybody was like, wow, and saying, good job. So this happened back ago, and later on, I still stuck in the pool. And finally, yeah, I got faster and faster, and I just always remembered where I want to go, where I want to be. And I'm just so grateful, the people who were around me, my family, all my coaches, and everybody who just ever supported me and helped me just never give up and always follow the dreams. And everything is possible, even though if you are sometimes under the water for 30 seconds. If you really, really want to do something, you can do it. And you just have to fight and never give up. And I was just 15 years old when I went to the Olympic Games in Atlanta. I was very, very young, and my coach around that time, it was László Kiss, he coached Krisztina Gerszegi too. And he just always told me, you just have to come here to learn and no pressure. And still I was so excited, everything was so new. And I got the bronze medal, and I just probably haven't even realized what I did. And later on, when I got off to the plane and I returned to home, I just told to myself, Sydney gonna be my game, and I'm gonna go for the gold. So basically after that, I just probably woke up every single day, and I just see that I have to do everything to get that medal, to get the gold. And it was really hard and so much work, and probably I swam around the world, maybe not even once, but I just knew what I want. So finally I went to Sydney, and I got what I wanted, what I dreamed of. It was not easy, and it was very, very close. It was, I think, around 2/10, but I did it. And it was just a great experience. And after that, I also had a dream when I was little. I always wanted to come here to the United States, and I wanted to get education here. So I came to college, and I got a degree here, and it was just so great being a college swimmer and just experience a different culture, a different everything what's going on here, and I just loved it. So I lived here for 4 years, and it was a great time, and I'm just so pleased I can be back for this purpose. So I just would like to say thank you again for everybody who helped me and who helped to organize this, to Bruce. And I think that's all. Have fun to everybody.
Presenting the mantle, Steve Lundquist.